welcome back to my channel, and if you're new to my channel, then a warm welcome to my channel. My name is Pooja and I make videos on food, lifestyle, love and more. So if you do love my content, okay, love is a big word, if you do like my content, then give it a big thumbs up, click on that red subscribe button and the bell icon right next to it so that you don't miss out on my upcoming videos. So last week I posted a video about my recent travel that I did maybe 2 weeks back. So we had to go to Bangalore to... The reason was we came to Chennai in March for a week to stay with my in-laws. But after we came, 3 days later, there was the curfew and the nationwide lockdown. So we got stuck in Chennai for the next 6 months and our stuffs was... Sorry, we're stuck in Chennai. We were stuck in Chennai for the next 6 months and our stuff were stuck in Bangalore. So we had our friends move them and so we had to go collect our stuffs from our friends. So we thought, why waste this chance, because the lockdown was quite relaxed and people were traveling. So we thought, we were scared actually if the lockdown might continue a little bit later. So we thought, you know, not to waste the chance. So we just went and got our stuffs back from Bangalore. So that was the reason why we had to travel. It was not leisure travel or anything like that. So just wanted to make it clear. So yeah, I had a lot of questions from people asking how I applied for the e-pass or where we stayed and what was the procedure. Did we have checking when we came back into Tamil Nadu? So this video, I'm going to cover all those topics. And yeah, let's get into the video.
Hi you guys. Okay, sorry. Hey you guys, welcome back to our channel. So I hope you enjoyed the last video where we were traveling from Chennai to Bangalore. So today is the 21st of September. That's my husband cleaning the car. So yeah, today is the 21st of September and we are on our way back to Chennai from Bangalore. So we're done with all the work that we intended to do, and yeah, so I'm gonna take you along with me in this journey, because Chennai to Bangalore was very, very easy. As you would have already seen, there was no checking, and though we were prepared, there was no checking, no one stopped us in between and all that. But Bangalore to Chennai, since we're crossing borders and we're entering into Tamil Nadu, there we are expecting one or two places where we might be checked. So yes, the safety kit is here and our snack pack is here. So the mask is here and Hubster is somewhere. I don't know where he is. So yes, I hope you enjoy the rest of the video and do stick around till the end. And if you do like the content, then consider subscribing to our channel. And yeah, see you around.
So the first question was about the e-pass procedure. So when we started talking about traveling, we kept like we wanted to travel ever since July, but of course the lockdown was just keeping on extending. So we were continuously checking on what the process of the e-pass was and all that. So the rules just kept updating. So at the time that we went, we had to take e-pass only to enter Tamil Nadu from another state. So if you're traveling within Tamil Nadu, you still don't need an e-pass. But if you're going to another state and if you're returning back to Tamil Nadu, then you will need an e-pass to enter Tamil Nadu. So we took an e-pass only to enter. So that will be from Karnataka to Chennai. So we didn't take any e-pass while going, and we really did not have any hassle while traveling from Chennai to Bangalore. No one stopped us. No checkposts were actually there. I mean, checkposts were there, but it was completely empty. So yeah, please remember, if you're traveling within Tamil Nadu, you don't need an e-pass. But if you're traveling from another state into Tamil Nadu, then you will need an e-pass. So where you get an e-pass is the website. I'll give you the website right here. It's tnepass.tnega.org. This is the website where you apply for e-pass. So what happens is, as soon as you enter this website, it'll ask you to enter your mobile number and it'll give you a number, and you just have to copy that number into the next box and click on submit. So once you do that, you'll get an OTP. Just enter the OTP in the box and click on submit again. It'll take you to the home page. So in that home page, you'll have a different number of categories. So you'll have travel by road, travel by air, travel by train, if you're traveling as an individual or if you're traveling as a group. So just choose the option that's relevant to you. So what I chose was individual/group travel by road, because we were obviously traveling by car. So that was the option that I chose. And once I chose that option, it took me to another page. Not page really, it was the form actually that I had to fill out. So the first thing that it'll ask you is the reason for travel. So when I clicked on reason, it has a drop down button. So when I clicked on reason, it gave me a number of options like marriage or death or medical emergency. So many options like that. Excuse. So now when I checked the TNEPAS website, the options have actually changed. They have added tourism and all that. The option that we chose was returning of stranded people, because that was the only option that had the sub option of taking an e-pass to enter into Tamil Nadu. So remaining options like marriage and all that, they did not have that sub option. So that was the option that we chose, and it will ask you for a lot of details like your phone number, the person who's actually driving. So I gave my husband's details. So I gave his name, his father's name, our permanent address, and it will also take in the details of the passengers that you're traveling with. So in my case, it was only me who was the extra person. So if you're traveling by car, and if it's a 5-seater car, so you can include the driver plus 3 people. So this was again the condition when we traveled. I'm not sure if it's changed now. I checked on the internet. I don't think it's changed. So you can just keep yourself updated with all those things. So yeah, and it also asked us for our proof. So I think we gave passport, if I'm not wrong. Yeah. And you'll have to upload a soft copy of your passport. And in the next page, so once you give all these details, you can just click on next. If there's any error, it'll tell you that there's an error. So you can just correct that error, and you can again click on next, and it'll take you to the next page. I think in the next page, you will have to enter the details of the passenger. So in this case, I had to enter my details. So I gave my name, my age, the gender, and my address proof. Again, it was the passport. So next, when you click on next, it'll ask you one or two more questions. I'm not quite sure what it was. I don't remember. So yeah, once you've given all the necessary details, you can just click on submit, and instantaneously you will get your e-pass. So once you receive that, it'll give you an option to download it as PDF. So once you download it, what the e-pass, so it will have your car number and all that, and it'll also have a few details of the name of the driver, in this case my husband. So the name of the driver and the car number, a few details like that, from which state to which state you're entering and all that. The next page will have a lot of rules and regulations that you need to follow during the travel. So in our case, in the e-pass itself, it was written you need to take a color printout of the e-pass and stick it in the car's windshield. What do you call that? Windshield? Car's windshield. So yeah, so we took a color printout of that and we stuck it on the left side corner of the windshield, so that when we are entering, the police can see that and know that we've taken an e-pass and we're traveling. So yeah, this is the procedure for the e-pass. So the next question we got asked frequently was, did we have checking? We actually thought we would have checking. That's why we stuck the e-pass and all that. We had our proofs ready with us. They will ask you to carry the original document. So in my case, I gave my Aadhaar card and I had given my husband's passport, I believe. So we were carrying the original documents with us. Please be careful when you're carrying original government documents. So yeah, we were carrying all that, and we were also asked, apart from the color printout, we were also asked to take a black and white printout and carry it in hand. So yeah, these were the documents that we carried. So you'll need to take two copies of the e-pass, one color copy and one normal Xerox copy. So the color copy, you will have to stick the yellow page, the first page with all the details of your car and all that. You will have to stick it on the windshield of your car. And the next black and white document along with the government original proofs, you'll need to carry it in hand. So we were exiting Hosur and we were told that we will have a checking in Attibele, if I'm not wrong. So that's between Hosur and Krishnagiri. We did actually see the checking going on, but luckily no one stopped us. Like, people were being checked and cars were being stopped, bikes were being stopped and all that. You will see it in the video. We were actually not stopped at all. No one asked us to stop. They did see the sticker, but no one asked us to stop. I think the sticker was enough, but I'm not too sure. So I can't assure you if you will not be stopped at all. So just follow the procedure that's given in the rules that's given in the e-pass, and I think you should be good to go. So the next topic that we're going to cover is where we stayed. We of course have our families staying in Bangalore. I have my sister's, my cousin's house, and Gautam has a lot of his friend's house. I have my own aunt and uncle's house, but even Gautam's sister is there, but we did not go and visit any of them because of course we were coming from another state and we didn't want to, you know, risk their staying there. So that's why we did not go to any of our relatives' house. We were staying in a hotel. So while booking the hotel, we were very, very sure, or rather I was very, very skeptical, first of all, about the safety and the safety procedures that the hotel might follow. So what we made sure was, even if we have to pay a little extra, because we had to stay 3 nights, so even if we had to pay a little extra, that's completely fine as long as the hotel is very, very safe. So it's been 2.5-3 weeks, and touch wood, me and Gautam are fine. So I think it's a big thumbs up to the hotel that we stayed in. So we stayed in Radha Hotel. It's a Sarovar hotel, it's a 4-star hotel. So it was a little on the expensive side. So for 3 nights, I think we paid close to 6,000 or 7,000. So it is a little bit on the expensive side, but given the current situation, we really did not want to risk on the safety factor. So that's the reason we booked that hotel. And yeah, the hotel was actually surprisingly, it was really, really nice. We had all our baggages, even the little covers that I was carrying in hand, all of them were sanitized as soon as we entered. And they have a lot of vinyl stickers on the floor asking you to stand in that particular place for the current situation. And we were told that we had a room with breakfast. So we were like, I was like, buffet in this current situation. So they were like, madam, you don't worry, you can just call the room service and you can just give whatever order you want and we will get the breakfast to your room. So we were pleasantly surprised by that, and we thought they'll again have some limitations, like you can only order 2 idlis or two dosas or something like that, but that's not the case at all. You can order any amount of food that you want because breakfast is free, and you can just enjoy. The food was really good and the place was really, really amazing. Given the Bangalore's climate, we enjoyed the place thoroughly. There's a big window from the room, so every morning we used to wake up and open the curtain, and the view used to be amazing. It used to be green and it was raining and it was so romantic. We of course were not planning for a romantic getaway, but somehow it happened. So we really enjoyed our time there, and every morning after breakfast we took a walk around the property. It was really beautiful, it was very scenic. So if anyone's looking to travel to Bangalore, and if you're okay with the amount that we paid for three nights, then do check out this hotel. It's really nice. I'll leave a link for it in the description box below, so do check it out. So the next topic I wanted to cover was traveling in cab. Yes, we did travel in cabs because obviously traveling for 6 hours straight, Gautam's back was aching a little, and we had to go to a few of our friends' house to collect our stuffs. My friends helped me to shift the items, so it was divided between two of my friends, so we had to go and collect it from them. I think we booked Uber. We had to take cab twice or thrice, and we booked Uber, and I was so shocked to see the condition of the car. It was really good because the driver's seat alone was covered completely from the car roof itself with a plastic sheet. So it is transparent, you can see the driver can see you, but even your breath won't reach the driver. It was so safe, and every car that we traveled had a water bottle and a sanitizer for the passengers. So out of the 4 cars that we traveled, 3 of them had this plastic covering for the driver, between the driver and the passenger. So that's a real big thumbs up. You can travel tension free in Bangalore as of now. And again, we took only Uber. I'm not sure how Ola is. So yeah, Uber, a big thumbs up for what you're doing, because I think this gives the passengers a little more confidence and assurance that you can travel safe. So yes. Next, I wanted to share with you what I carried in my safety kit. So I had a big kit, and I carried these items in hand with me, so I did not put it inside any luggage bag or anything. I had it in hand with me so that I can take it anytime I want. So the first product that I had inside it were sanitizing wipes. So this is from the brand Savlon, so we know Savlon is just like Dettol. So they had these sanitizing wipes, just like you have a wet wipe. The next one is disposable gloves. So I got these disposable plastic gloves from Amazon, and I thought it will be really helpful because we do use it while going for shopping to the local supermarket. So yeah, I carried my disposable gloves. The next is obviously tissues, because you can never have enough tissues, right? So yeah, next is dry tissues. The next one is sanitizer. Obviously, you can't travel in the current situation without a sanitizer. So the next one was a Lifebuoy sanitizer, I believe. The next one is actually a surprise. It's a small hand wash that you get from the brand Dettol. So it's called Dettol Squeezy. It's a 30 rupees ka hand wash. The next is disposable masks, because yeah, obviously given the current situation, you need multiple masks even if you're traveling for a day. So I carried some disposable masks as well. And the last one is Dettol spray. Again, this is an antibacterial sanitizing spray from the brand Dettol. So we used it for using public toilets, which was not much, but I didn't have the chance to use many public toilets, thankfully. So I just carried this just in case if I needed. So this is what I carried in my safety kit. Plus I carried my normal medicines that you'll need, like Dolo and all that for fever, cold and all that. So yeah, I carried my safety kit plus my medicine kit. So yes, that's all for this video. I hope you really enjoyed this video, and if you did, then give it a big thumbs up, click on that red subscribe button and the notification bell next to it so that you don't miss my upcoming videos, and I'll see you guys next time. Till then, bye.